من أساليب الدعوة إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى الحكمة, the methods of دعوة to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, you have to have wisdom, like what Allah سبحانه وتعالى said in Surah An-Nahl verse 125. When you invoke somebody to Allah, you start making دعوة, you make the job of the Anbiya. Before you give the maw'iza, the advice, you have to be wise. And there are too many methods for that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Udu'u, start with Dhamma, because the last, third letter with Dhamma, Bish. Udu'u, to order. Udu'u ila sabila rabbika bil hikmati wal maw'idhati al-hasana. Wajadilhum billati hiya ahsan. Inna rabbaka huwa a'lamu biman dhalla an sabilihi wa huwa a'lamu bil muhtadin. When you call people to Allah, to sabil of Allah, your Lord, you have to have wisdom before the maw'iza. He said wisdom bil hikmah first before the maw'iza. Al maw'iza al hasana, like what Allah said. And you have to debate with them and to make argument, not arguments, I can say dialogue. It's the best word you can say it in this, dialogue with them in a good way. But why? Because you're standing instead of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam delivering his message. That's why you have to be responsible for that. Let's see the meaning of al-hikmah in the Quran and the Sunnah. Al-hikmah has to be the, that's why we talk about methods of da'wah, methods, turuq, too many ways. Fal-hikmah also, the word of hikmah has too many meanings. Minha, number one, al-hikmah bima'na al-Quran wa sunnah wa bayan al-shara'ah. Al-hikmah means wisdom. It's real, sometimes comes the meaning of al-Quran. When you read the word hikmah means the Quran. Hikmah also means sunnah. سبحان الله. And also the شريعة of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. You can call it حكمة too. I give you the دليل. سورة البقرة verse 129. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said ربنا وابعث فيهم, when Prophet Ibrahim and his son Ishmael, they finished both of them raising الكعبة. الكعبة was the foundation, was their ملائكة, they put it already. وذي يرفع إبراهيم القواعد من البيت وإسماعيل. After they finish raising the foundation of the كعبة, they make this dua for almost 4,000 years before the coming of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Imagine that they make the dua, Allah answered after 4,000 years. This is between Sayyidina Ibrahim and Rasulullah. This is يعني almost this time. What they say, both of them, Rabbana, our Lord, وابعث فيهم رسولا منهم, send from amongst them رسول, who Arab people, because the Kaaba was there, Arabia, land of Arabia. What's his job? قال يتلو عليهم آياتك, to recite your verses to them, ويعلمهم الكتاب, and to teach them الكتاب, the book, والحكمة, some scholars say the سنة, ويزكيهم, and to purify them, إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم, you are almighty indeed and all wise. فابن القيم رحمه الله, he said الحكمة in the book of Allah سبحانه وتعالى two types. حكمة مفردة comes alone individually and sometimes comes مقترنة with the book. فالمفردة, if Allah said الحكمة itself without the book means the sunnah. Means the sunnah. طيب, if it, الحكمة comes with the book like this آية, علوم الكتابة والحكمة, means the Quran. Means what? The Quran and this الشريعة. And sometimes it comes also like الإمام الضحاك said, القرآن والفهم به. And Quran and understanding the Quran. Imam Mujahid, all of this, Dhahak wa Mujahid wa Udol, they were the students of Abdullah ibn Abbas. Fadhahak said, or Imam Mujahid said, هي القرآن, الحكمة منز القرآن. Some of them, he said, الحكمة منز الفقه, understanding of الفقه. Anyway, Imam al-Nakhi said, all these معاني, meanings. Some of them, like Imam al-Hasan ibn Ali رضي الله عنه, said, الحكمة منزل الورع في دين الله, how to, يعني to have more taqwa and fear of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And the حكمة comes itself مفردة individually with the meaning of what? النبوة, the prophethood. And the دليل from the Quran, سورة صاد verse 20, Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, وَشَدَدْنَا مُلْكَهُ وَآتَيْنَاهُ الْحِكْمَةَ وَفَصْلَ الْخِطَابِ. وَشَدَدْنَا مُلْكَهُ وَآتَيْنَاهُ الْحِكْمَةَ وَفَصْلَ الْخِطَابِ. Who? Prophet سليمان. We give him big kingdom. He was a king, Suleiman, and Dawood, his father. We gave him big mulk. وآتيناه الحكمة. We give him wisdom. Wisdom means what? النبوة, prophethood. وفصل الخطاب. He knew how to judge people. الحكمة also comes with the understanding and the wisdom of your brain according to the Sharia. Like سورة لقمان, chapter of لقمان, verse number 12. الله سبحانه وتعالى said, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا لُقْمَانَ الْحِكْمَةِ. We give لقمان الحكمة. لقمان, he used to live in Sudan. Sudan. He was a Sudanese guy. He was very tall, skinny, big nose, big ears, small head, and tall. So you see him, slave, servant for his master. عبد. And one time his master, he said, يا لقمان, go slaughter sheep and get me the best of it and the worst of it. And so he did. And he gave him what? The tongue and the heart. And they said, the tongue can be the worst and can be the best. The same thing the heart too. He said, you are so wise. Subhanallah, you are so wise. فالله سبحانه وتعالى سمى سكارة لابن كثير. He said, Allah gave him a choice between الحكمة or to be a prophet. He said, no, I don't want to be a prophet. I want to be a wise man. That's why Allah said, وَلَقَدْ أَتَيْنَا لُقْمَانَ الْحِكْمَةِ. We give him the wisdom. أي وَلَقَدْ أَتَيْنَا لُقْمَانَ. نشكر لله. Because of that, be grateful to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And if you will be grateful to Allah, gratitude to him, this is for your own self. لنفسه. ومن كفر, if you deny, Allah سبحانه وتعالى self, so he doesn't need you. الحكمة also comes with the meaning of an admonition. الموعظة, العظة. What is the meaning of الموعظة? الموعظة, it is not a خطبة جمعة. الموعظة, it is not a lecture. الموعظة, very short talks, but very strong words. Like رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he gave it to عمر بن الخطاب. He said what? كفى بالموت واعظا يا عمر. That's it. It's موعظة, an admonition. He said, it's enough for you to remember death. To remind you to be واعظ. Big موعظة. Very strong words and very المبنى. Few words and very strong. That's called موعظة. فالحكمة comes with this word too. That's why Allah said in Surah Al-Qamar, verse number 5. حكمة بالغة فما تغني النذر. It's a strong admonition. And Allah warned people too many times in the Holy Quran. المهم, the meaning here is we can understand الحكمة has too many meanings according to the sentence or the verse or the ayah. That's why the Arabic language, يا جماعة, it's the Arabic, the language of the Quran. Very deep and vast. There is no limit for this language. Subhanallah, see one word carrying too many meanings and comes into many ayat. That's why you have to know Arabic. If you don't know Arabic, I'm not saying to talk, to speak. No, anybody can speak Arabic. If you did not study in depth, the balagha, linguistic, the Quran, and all of that, the meaning and the مفردات الكلمات, the words, too many things, or الإعراب, don't talk about Quran, don't talk about tafsir at all. That's why I don't, with my respect, I don't believe all of these English tafsirs I read it before. I don't believe it. Because with my respect, these people, they translate this Quran literally, word by word. But if you ask them in Arabic language, they don't know nothing. They don't know nothing. With my respect to them, whom they did their ishtihad. But this is not tafsir at all. At all. Anyway, al-hikmah is very important. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, when you advise someone, don't show his shame to others. Take him individual in the side and tell him in a nice way, brother, jazakallah khair. For what you did, you're doing good job. You're doing hard for this. May Allah accept it from you. But I think you did mistake in this. Don't come in public. Hey, you don't know nothing. What did you do? And that happened to me when I was 24 years imam for 4,000 people in Amman in Jordan. Palestinian guy who was standing with big beard. He was Wahhabi. I was making mistake in Salat al-Maghrib. I forget part of the ayah or something. He did the Quran, he said, remember the color of the Quran, this Madani Quran, this in the top. Front of four lines, maybe it will be like 200 people in these four lines. And yeah, Sheikh make mistake, I say, oh, I make like somebody in the market, you know. I said, you're stupid, dumb. You don't know nothing. Sit down, Ahmar. I told him, you're Ahmar. You don't know nothing about Islam. Rasul said, جنبني الفضيحة عند النصيحة. When you advise me, don't show my shame. Come in the side in a nice way and talk politely. This is the way. I told you yesterday, Rasulullah, in the Hudaybiyah, when Abu Bakr, Umar, started raising his voice to Rasulullah, Abu Bakr told him, Erzam Gharzak, Ya Umar. You're talking to Rasulullah. Be polite. Yeah? You have to be polite. This is the way how you deal with people. Subhanallah. Otherwise, don't give advice because you're not qualified to give advice. if you're gonna attack like this way. For that's why very important. And I mentioned this too many times in my khutbah. When that young man came to Rasulullah, said, Ya Rasulullah, I want to make zina, adultery, illegal sexual intercourse. Arabi will, as usual, come hate him like the one who want to urinate in the masjid. Same thing like what we are doing. Ya Allah, beat him up. Rasulullah says, no, let him finish. Was what? Imagine Qasim by somebody in the back of the masjid, he said, I want to urinate. Are you going to let him finish? You're going to beat him up. Of course, he's not supposed to do that. That Bedouin man, he came from the desert, he did not know nothing. Sahaba, they jump on him to beat him up. Rasulullah said, La tuzrimu. Do you know what's mean, La tuzrimu? Let him finish. Don't harm him. Let him finish. In a nice way, he told him, man, listen, this masajid is not for this. This masjid for zikr Allah, salah al-ibadah. And he said, Allahumma have mercy, Allah have mercy on me and Muhammad, not his people. He said, Rasul started laughing again. He said, لَقَدْ ضَيَقْتَ وَسَعَنِي رَجُلْ. Rahmat Allah is very big and wide and wasa'a for everybody. Why you make it just for me? Do you? This is what he know. Subhanallah. Anyway, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when that man, young boy, he been addicted to illegal sexual intercourse before his Islam. Young boy. He said, Ya Rasulullah, I want to do it. I'm praying, I'm going to the masjid, I'm coming to you, I love you, I love Islam, but I cannot hold myself. I love women. I'm a woman. Get out openly. I'm very womanizer man. I like illegal sexual intercourse. I like zina. Allow me, Ya Rasulullah. The Sahaba, they said, Mah. Mah. Mah in Arabic means, Hajar said that word. Remember, between Safa and Marwa? Mah. Mah. She was looking for water. Mah means, be quiet, silent. Listen. Shh. Listen. The Sahaba, they start, listen. Hush. What are you talking about? They start. Rasulullah said, come. Nice way. He was holding his shoulder. Nice way. Do you accept this for your mom, for your sister, for your daughter, for your aunt? Each time he said, A'udhu billahi ya Rasulullah, never. He said, people like you, they will never accept this to their moms, to their sisters, to their... In a nice way, and in the end he make dua for him, Allahumma aghfir dhanbah, oh Allah forgive his sin. Washrah sadrah, subhanAllah, purify his heart from any kind of sin. Wahassin farjah, protect his private parts. That man, young boy, he said, I never think about it anymore. But look to the way Rasulullah, wisdom is very important. Yes, yeah, doctor, but he is not just wisdom, is etiquette. Wisdom when to say something in the right way, in the right time. This is لكل مقام مقال. This is the meaning. This is the meaning of wisdom. To put everything in its spot, in its time, for its person, for the right person, for too many things. And you have to evaluate people when you talk to them too. Somebody scholar, you have to talk to him as a scholar. Somebody his limit like this, you have to give him, to talk him according to his limit too. You cannot evaluate people like each other. When you talk to them also, you have to evaluate somebody. If you go to, for example, to the judge for the court, what do? You wear a good suit and you comb yourself, you put perfume, yeah, your honor, okay, we're making like this. If you talk to somebody else, is your friend, is different. Is somebody scholar, you have to show some respect. Somebody, you have to evaluate people. This is the way. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said kida, anzilu nasa manazilahum. Anzilu nasa manazilahum. You have to put people in their spot and you have to deal with them according to this way. Anyway, al-hikmah is very important. And al-hikmah is full of khair. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the end of Surah Al-Baqarah, وَمَنْ يُؤْتَ الْحِكْمَةِ فَقَدْ أُوْتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. If Allah gave someone al-hikmah, this is a lot of khair. There is nothing better than that. خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. The best thing if Allah gave you wisdom. That's why Luqman, according to Ibn Kathir, when he get the choice to be a Nabi, a prophet, or a wise man, he said, no, I don't want to be a Nabi. I want to be a wise man. Subhanallah. So that's why I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabbi, to give us al-hikmah, wal-maw'adha al-hasana, and to give us, يعني, subhanallah, sabr al-jameel, inshallah, Ya Rabbi al-alameen, to deliver the message of Allah Azza wa Jal, the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Arham al-Rahim, Rabbana taqabbal minna, wa aghfir lana, wa arhamna, wa asturna, wa ajburna, wa ahdina, wa afina, wa akrimna, Ya Rabbi al-alameen. Allahumma rizqna al-hilma wal-ilma wal-hikma, Ya Arham al-Rahimeen. ربنا تقبل منا واسترنا واجبرنا يا رب احفظنا جميعا واياكم من بين ايدينا ومن خلفنا وعلى ايماننا وعن شمالنا واجعلنا لك يا ربنا من الشاكرين اشف مرضانا واشف مرضى المسلمين وانصر اخواننا في غزه يا رب اللهم انصرهم اللهم كن معهم يا رب اللهم انصر اخواننا في غزه اللهم احقن دماءهم احقن دماء الشباب والشابات واحقن دماء الشيوخ يا رب والرجال والنساء وكن معهم يا رب واحفظهم جميعا يا ارحم الراحمين كن معهم بحفظك ورعايتك يا ارحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين واحفظنا جميعا والمسلمين اجمعين يا ارحم الراحمين نسالك من الخير كله عاجله واجله ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله واجله وصلى اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم.